All right, so I'm back with the Nitro Slash, and now let's go. I want to go talk about what was the delay. Why was there a long delay on my Traxxas Nitro Slash? Last time I driven this thing was when my cousins and my uncles and aunts who came from the UK. By the way, they came from Bristol all the way here to the States back in early August. That was the last time I ever driven the Nitro Slash, is when they were, when my family from the UK came over by to the United States. So what caused the delay? What caused the 1 month delay of me not driving my Nitro Slash? Simple. I was having some tuning problems, and I was having some issues with the car not moving at all. And let me elaborate on this. So basically, when I start her up, it does crank. It does turn on. The engine does turn on and start up. The only problem is I have to keep the car lifted up. I have to let the drive wheels up so it can have a start. But as soon as I apply the brakes or I drop the rear wheels down to the ground, it immediately kills itself. And I know what you're thinking. It's probably your carburetor. It's probably not, it's not open a little bit. And I tried that, none of that worked, and I almost had to give up on it. So, I know it may sound stupid, but I had to take this car to my local hobby shop to let them fix it up for me. I'm still fairly new with Nitro RCs. I don't really own Nitro RCs. This is the only Nitro RC I have in my collection, and probably will only be the only one Nitro I ever own out of my RC collection. So I took it to my local hobby shop, let them fix it for me, and plus I had to give it to them because I didn't really have enough time nor the luxury to actually work it on myself, even if I really wanted to. I wanted to actually work with the engine and stuff like that, but I had to give it to the professionals first before I actually do any tinkering with it myself. So at least they can give me advice that, oh, this is this and this is that and such and such and such. So I gave it to them. And it took them like a business week just to get it fixed up. And once they were done, they actually told me that the clutch assembly, the clutch shoes and the spring were all screwed up. They're already done, basically. So, and I said that was the only thing that went wrong in it. And they said, yes, aside from a tuning issue, that was pretty much it. So they did the tuning. They did all the clutch works itself, and now it runs perfectly. As you can see from my previous video that I posted just like a day ago, depending on what time you watch this video. If you guys seen that video of my Nitro Slash running after 1 month of inactivity, it runs phenomenal. And I really give thanks to my local hobby shop for fixing up the car for me. I really appreciate that. And they also gave me some tips. So whenever if I want to work on my Nitro RC for in the future, I'll keep that in mind. So yeah, that's the reason why that my Nitro Slash has been inactive for about a month. It's been over a month since this thing has been driven, and I give huge thanks to my local hobby shop of fixing my RC, my Nitro RC. So yeah. So anyways, guys, this is FHR Cibroni with the Nitro Slash once again, and I'll talk to you guys again soon.